Hi everyone! This tutorial explains how to generate and apply secondary structure restraints. At resolutions lower than about 3 angstrom, refinement of coordinates may be unstable. In particular, secondary structure elements may be distorted. However, using specifically designed secondary structure restraints may help preserving their geometry, and slightly distorted elements might be corrected. Note that this applies to refinement against X-ray or cryo-EM data. First, let's revise secondary structure. Secondary structure elements of proteins are helices and sheets. Helices can be subdivided into 310, alpha, and pi type, according to the hydrogen bond pattern. For example, the most common helix is the alpha helix, with hydrogen bonds between the peptide units of residue N and residue N plus 4. Sheets can be parallel or antiparallel, depending on the direction of the main chain. Secondary structure elements for nucleic acids are base pairs and stacking pairs. Base pairs have typically a somewhat planar configuration, and stacking nucleotides are parallel to each other. If secondary structure restraints are enabled, interactions specific to these elements will be restrained during refinement. For example, in helices, this will be the NO bond lengths and the following angles: the NOC angle, the C alpha NO angle, and the CNO angle. Note that this is in addition to any other restraints applied, such as usual bond and angle restraints. To apply secondary structure restraints, it is necessary to supply an annotation which tells the program which residues belong to a secondary structure element. Annotations can be supplied in several ways. First, they can be stored as helix and sheet records in the model file. The records can be obtained by using external programs. Also, they are typically present in files downloaded from the PDB. Secondly, the Phoenix Refine and RealSpace Refine GUIs can perform the annotations. Finally, the standalone command line tool phenix.secondarystructurerestraints can supply input files for Phoenix, and it can also create helix and sheet records. There's also an option to create a PyMol script, which allows visualization of bond and angle restraints to be applied, such as in this helix. The algorithm in the GUI and in this tool is the same. It should be noted that secondary structure annotation is based on the input model geometry, so a poor input model is likely to generate a suboptimal annotation. If a higher resolution homologue model is available, consider using it for generating the annotations. Now, I will show how to obtain annotations in the Phoenix Refine GUI. I will show afterwards where to enable secondary structure restraints for Phoenix RealSpace Refine. In the main Phoenix window, click on Refinement and choose Phoenix Refine. In the new window, click Add File to add your model and data files. Make sure that the space group, unit cell parameters, and data labels are correct. Don't forget to add a title for the run. Then go to the tab Refinement Settings. In the Targets and Weighting section, enable the Use Secondary Structure Restraints checkbox. Then click on Select Atoms in the Strategy field. A new window opens. The leftmost tab is for the secondary structure, which will not be present if the restraints checkbox was not activated. There are four subtabs called helices, beta sheets, base pairs, and stacking pairs. Click on the Find Secondary Structure button in any of the tabs. A new window opens which gives options for secondary structure restraints. If the checkbox Ignore Annotation and File is disabled, annotations provided in the input file will be used. If the box is enabled, the program will obtain annotations using the methods specified in the Search Method drop-down menu. For this example, let's use default values. The program saves the annotation in a .f file, which can be used as reference or as input file for future refinements. The tabs contain now annotations for secondary structure elements. Click on the Model button in the top of the Selection Editor window, which opens the Model Viewer. If you click on any structure element, it will be highlighted, such as this helix. You can also highlight entire sheets by selecting all lines at once. It is important to double-check the secondary structure assignment, as it may happen that automatic procedures have some errors. For example, let's look at this helix, which is in chain A and runs from residue 296 to 315. This is how this helix looks like in isolation. There's a clear bend in the helix. When we draw the H bonds between peptide units, it can be clearly seen that the network is interrupted. The restraints algorithm has some safeguards to prevent that, for example, this oxygen atom and this nitrogen atom are considered bonded. However, it is preferable to supply the correct annotation. So please check your annotations manually in a molecular viewer. If you have corrections, you can input them into the selection editor. Let's say we only consider the fragment on the right as alpha helix. It runs from residue 302 to 315. In the editor, click on the helix and change the residue range accordingly. Once you think the annotation is correct, hit save and close. If you don't have other options to change, you can start the refinement. To apply secondary structure restraints in Phoenix Real Space Refine, use the checkbox in the strategy section and then proceed to the Select Atoms button. I hope this tutorial was helpful. If you have any questions, contact us at help@phoenix-online.org or tutorials@phoenix-online.org.